manufacturer ID or manufacturer identification code. What do you put in here? And who is manufacturer? Is it the producer? Is it the middleman who buys and sells? Is it the shipper? Can it be the agent? Same concept that we explored with the blessing, with the importer of record. Who is the importer? Who has the right to make an entry? Or who can be the consignee? Who cannot be the consignee? Those concepts continue to hunt us down when we come to the notion of manufacturer identification code. It's a required box. It's a required block that you need to check, that you need to put the number in, and it's subject to certain rules, kind of like the rules that we dealt with when we were talking about the entry number construction. Remember, there is a formula for doing the check digit. Well, there are similar rules for the MID code, MID code construction, but before that, you have an invoice, and the invoice tells you, for example, you have the party which is says let's say the exporter, and you have a party that says let's say producer, who do you put as your manufacturer identification pool? Because invoicing party, invoice may have both, but the invoicing party will be the exporter because you are dealing with the invoicing party, the exporter. I have manufacturer that makes paper cups with plastic top. Well, do you think one entity makes plastic tops and paper cups? Probably not. Because equipment is different, the necessity for production is different, the machinery is different. So you have one manufacturer that makes this, another manufacturer that makes that, and then you have a finished product, which is sold to the ultimate consumer as one piece. Paper cup with the top. And even with the paper cup, since it's designed to hold heat hot products like coffee or tea, You can have some kind of wrapping around paper. So in this case, it is designed with some kind of foam, which is made out of probably some kind of plastic compound, like polyurethane or something like that, to sink in the heat so I don't burn my fingers when I pour it on. So who makes that plastic part? It's multiple entities, all right? So in this concept, we can have many manufacturers that make many goods, or we can have many manufacturers that make one product. So let's take a look at how it's done. So it has 15 characters. And there are no spaces. It's just like one alphanumeric combination. So you have notice it's 15 characters, but it doesn't have to be 15 characters. Usually, very often it's less than 15, but the 15 is the upper limit. No more than 15. So back in 1987, Canada and United States, 1987 was a time before harmonized tariff schedule was even in force. You had tariff schedule of the United States. It was not harmonized with other countries. It was in process of being organized. So in those days, Canada and United States, two neighbors, they came to the agreement where they decided to, for statistical purposes, for trade, purposes, they decided to identify not the country itself, but the state or the province. So the products are going to the Canada. I believe they use the state. So if it comes from United States to Canada, it would usually be identified as Wyoming, California, New York. And the other way around for Canada, if it comes from Ontario, you identify Ontario in those two spaces. In those two spaces of the country code. So you treat really the province as a country in the cases of Canada. So here, our E.K. Rogers example, which our famous E.K. Rogers example in England, here is one Hawthorne Lane. Where does anyone see the number here? No, because there are no numbers. There is like one, right? But you do not convert it. So even if it has no digits, you are not here to fill in the blanks for digits. You stick to the old rule, do not make stuff up, and use, if there are no numbers, oh well, no numbers means no numbers. So you go to the next rule.